Reiki deals with binding, but cosmologically it deals with the binding of the spirits of the ancestresses and ancestors and the deities through spirit possession. And when the spirits possess our people just like they did in the past, they possess our people today during rituals and hoodoo and voodoo and juju and so forth. The ancestresses and ancestors and the deities possess, they bind themselves to us, Reiki, and then they bring a message of wisdom, bring a message of divinity, direction from the divine order coming from the supreme being, Amenet and Amen. So, when we talk about reliquing and so forth, rebinding for wisdom, attunement to the supreme being, we're talking about Reikit, and this is why we have a class of spirits as well as human beings in ancient Kemet called the Reikit. Reikitu, the wise ones, but they're wise because they are spirit mediums. They are those who become possessed or horses for the spirits, become mounted by the deities through spirit possession, spirit communication. Mounted by the ancestresses and ancestors, the Aku, the Akutu, through spirit possession, spirit communication. We have them in ancient Kemet, in Kanik. We have them in Akan, we have them in Yoruba, we have them in Okwodun, the people who are horses, people who get mounted by the spirits, those are the Reikitu. So that connection between Rek or Lek, Leki, Lechi, Leg, and so forth, re-legging, re-ligging, religio, and all of that, that comes directly from Reikit, Reket, Rekut, and so forth in ancient Kemet, not just meaning the male and female force of divine wisdom, but talking about that binding force, binding the spirit in the body of the person so they can bring a message of wisdom to the community. This is the cosmology the whites and their offspring do not have.